Are you having problems with melting potted plants? Are you looking for an alternative? Or are you scared or skeptical about in vitro plants? You shouldn't be, because in vitro plants might be just what you need. In this video, we will cover the advantages and disadvantages of in vitro plants, talk about how to use them, and more. In vitro plants, also known as tissue culture plants, are aquarium plants that are grown in sterilized laboratory environment. These plants are grown from very small pieces of plant tissue, which are then placed into nutrient-rich gel that allows them to develop roots and grow into mature plant. In vitro plants are sold in small plastic containers, just like these ones. These containers are filled with that gel that provides everything that those plants need to grow. There are many plant types that can be bought in vitro form, including very popular stem plants, epiphytes, carpeting plants, and mosses. Okay, so we know what in vitro plants are. Let's talk about their benefits. First of all, we have to talk about sterility. As I said already, in vitro plants are grown in sterilized laboratory environment. That means that they are completely free from all the risks associated with potted plants. What risks? For instance, with in vitro plants, there are no chances to get unwanted guests, like pest snails. They do not carry any eggs of any parasites. But also, there is no chance to get unwanted foreign plants like duckweed or unwanted moss. All you get is clean, specific type of your plant and absolutely nothing else. Second advantage is the cost. This one might sound contradicting to what many people are saying, but in my opinion, in vitro plants, in the long run, are actually cheaper than their potted versions. This is because of the number of individual plants that you will find in each portion. Even though in vitro cups are more expensive than a single pot, in each cup there are many individual plants, much more than in potted versions. So, if you think of it as a price per individual plant, in vitro will always be much cheaper. Yes, they are obviously smaller, but for example, number of stems in this cup is around 3 to 4 times higher than in potted version of the same plant. I hope that makes sense. Next thing to talk about is the storage. It's very easy to store those plants by simply keeping them on the shelf. Just try to keep them in cooler place with some access to light. For example, indirect light from your tank, that would be perfect. This way, I always was able to keep them for a few weeks, depending on the plant type. In general, the faster the plant grows, like stems, the faster you should use it. With potted plants, you really need to have a dedicated tank or storage area with very high humidity to keep them alive. So you may imagine that if you have one or two tanks, it becomes a problem very quickly. Look here. I saved this Anubias in vitro form just to show you how it works. See those light green leaves, lighter than the others? All those leaves grew after I got this plant, and that was 4 weeks ago. The same with these roots right there. This plant is healthy, growing nicely, and can be used at any time for my next project. And all I did is just placed it on the shelf next to one of my tanks. Next thing on the list is simplicity. In vitro plants are very easy to prepare for planting. You no longer have to clean them from this annoying wool that potted plants come with. All you need to do is rinse them under warm water to clean the gel they come with, and you're good to go. And finally, they are quite good for the environment. this is something not impacting us very directly, but I do believe that for many of us, it's still important. And I think it's safe to say that we are all nature lovers and we do care about things like that. Production of in vitro plants is much more friendly for the environment. Plant producers can use a lot less water and occupy less space. And on top of this, we are using much less water to prepare the plants for planting. Trust me, on global scale, it really adds up. But to balance all of this out, we need to be aware about the disadvantages of in vitro plants. First of all, fragility. In vitro plants are much more delicate than the potted plants. So during planting, we need to be a little bit more careful with them and try not to crush or destroy them in the process. Second, their small size. Yes, they are very small, much smaller than their potted versions. This might be problematic during planting, especially because quite often they have very small root system, but it depends on the plant type. This also requires a little bit more planning on where and how close to each other you should plant certain plant types. With potted plants, you more or less see what to expect, how big they are, how many you have, and so on. With in vitro, it might not be obvious to envision the end result. Look here, this is Rotala atra in vitro version. Look how different it looks from its final form and how big and dense it got. And I have used only one cup and had a lot of leftovers. And lastly, slower growth. In vitro plants at the very beginning will start to grow immediately, but not very quickly, slower than the potted versions. They just need to adapt to a new environment before they really take off. And now I just want to share a few tips on how to deal with in vitro plants. First of all, it helps to acclimate the plants just like we do with fish. So, try to remove the plant from the container very gently, not to destroy it. Then rinse it in water and remove any gel. And then place the plants in some water from established tank for a few hours. Of course, if you have that available. This will be the first time when those plants will actually have contact with bacteria from your tank. Next thing to remember is that in vitro plants are grown in very nutrient-rich medium, and they may require additional nutrients to survive in your aquarium, especially at the very beginning. So consider adding some liquid fertilizers or root tubs to the substrate to provide those necessary nutrients. And now, you need to monitor the situation. Keep an eye on the plants after planting and ensure that they are adapting well to your aquarium environment. If you notice any issues like melting, discoloration, adjust the water parameters, fertilization, and lighting as needed. Remember, it takes time for the in vitro plants to really take off. And the plant mass at the very beginning is not very big, so you need to be a little extra careful to establish the balance between your fertilizer, light, and plant mass. In conclusion, in vitro plants offer a range of benefits to planted tanks. They are safe, easy to store, simple to plant. I know that they may look a little bit weird comparing them to the potted versions, but are not scary at all. Just remember to acclimate them, provide nutrients, monitor the plants to avoid common problems. With a little care and attention at the beginning, you can successfully use in vitro plants to create really beautiful and healthy planted aquariums.